Good afternoon, everyone. We'll be covering the topic on climate change. And this year, prelims exam 2020, climate change topic will be important for the examination. And you could expect 2 to 3 questions in as in the exam. If we analyze the previous year question paper, you will find at least minimum 2 questions come from climate change, right? So let us just go into different aspect of climate change where UPSC can ask question there. Now today, I am here in Pune, ICRA AES platform. So first of all, I thank the management here for inviting me for the class and thank all of you to be present in the classroom, because this is one platform in the regional center, Pune, where you are getting the faculties from Delhi, right, who are coming to the Pune and to deliver the respective topics there. So from environmental science and particularly from the UPSC point of view, since all these topics are getting dynamic year by year, and climate change is always a hot topic. Always you come across in newspaper, current affairs, right, website, even in the television channel, number of news articles come on the climate change aspect there. So let us understand different dimensions of climate change. We'll cover in today's class. So let us first start from a very renowned figure, Greta Thunberg. Right? She has created a kind of a wave, right, awareness all over the world. So she was selected as a Time magazine Man of the Year, but she is a woman. But so she has been selected in that way because of her effort to make people aware, right, to aware and take action for protecting the environment and the impact of global warming climate change, right. Now Greta Thunberg, she is a Swedish citizen, from Sweden she belongs there. So how her story starts, at the age of 8 years, right, very young age, 8 years, she learned about the science of climate change, right, which we will be covering in today's class, ki what is happening with the earth because of global warming climate change. At a very young age, she got all the information about scientific basis of global warming, climate change, and she was very much distressed about what going to be there on the earth and humans, biodiversity, because of climate change impact. So she started protesting outside the parliament of the Sweden to bring the attention of the government, public servant, to take action to protect earth from the climate change impacts. And then from there, she went all over the country, right? She even took a big protest with thousands of volunteers, young people, in front of the White House in USA, right? Now, because of her effort, climate change has become a big thing worldwide. Every country, even the young people are coming on the street and protesting against the government to take some action. Now let me bring about one more thing here. Europe, European Union and the Parliament has declared climate emergency. You'll come across in newspaper climate emergency. What do you mean by climate emergency? All these are in the news there. What do you mean by the term climate emergency? Right, this all has come. Australia, Europe, there have been governments worldwide which have solemnly has declared climate emergency. So what do you mean by the term climate emergency? Crisis. Now, correct, anything more? See, climate emergency word which has come in the recent time is not a very old term. It just came in 2017, right, when a mayor from Australia, Queensland, came out with the climate emergency and declared in its own urban area. Right, it was again endorsed by a number of leaders worldwide, plus that Pope Francis, the Catholic Church, also has endorsed the climate emergency. And recently what I said, Australia, Europe, they have endorsed through their parliament the climate emergency. What do you mean by climate emergency? It is an acknowledgement. Climate emergency is an acknowledgement by the government that climate change is imminent danger to mankind. And human beings are getting impacted because of climate change, and the human civilization is facing high risk and will be lost because of the climate change. There's a kind of a formal kind of recognition which the government want, and that is done through kind of a government measure. So when a government says climate emergency, declare a climate emergency through a parliament or some kind of statute or law or rules, it means that government will take action to protect the country from the climate change impacts. Like for example, sea level rise, or let's say hurricane, tornado, or let's say for example, heat waves, or you take about drought, flood, all these are because of the climate change impacts, right? So now this is a new thing has come. But if you take about developing country, let's say China, India, Brazil, South Africa, you will hardly come across the word climate emergency. What we are talking about? Citizenship amendment and citizenship emergency. But we are talking about the climate emergency. Though India is also facing the risk of climate change impact because of rising sea level, or it is a cyclone, or melting of glacier, we do have the impact on the country. But it is not a very hot word in India. And the government is not committed to go for that kind. But European country, Western countries, they are becoming more proactive. So that's what I've started with the Greater Thunberg. Now let's understand here. This is the what I brought in the classroom, climate emergency. And you can see the large mass of the people who are on the street protesting against a government for not taking action to protect the planet from the climate change impacts, right? Then coming to here, now comes the question, how the people have become very aware on climate change science or climate change impacts. So that goes to the IPCC, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, right? Now let's understand about IPCC. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change was set up in 1988 by a resolution passed by the United Nations General Assembly. The UN General Assembly felt the need that let there be a body, a dedicated organization, which can make the policy makers aware on the science of climate change and what impacts are there because of the rising temperature of Earth. Let's say 2 degrees Celsius, 3 degrees Celsius. Before that, there was science. Remember that. Science of climate and climate change has been there for a long time. It's not that something scientists have not been studying so far. Scientists have been doing research, conducting studies for a long time. But there was not a formal body to make the government realize what exactly is going on with the climate system. So IPCC was formed. And two organizations played an important role in making IPCC. One is the UNEP, United Nations Environment Programme, which is now called UNE, United Nations Environment. And second, very dedicated agency of UN called WMO, World Meteorological Organization, which looks into meteorological science worldwide. They came together in 1988, formed this body, IPCC. And what IPCC does? What is the objective of IPCC? You all have been reading current affairs, IPCC reports and all. So what IPCC work? It brings about comprehensive report on climate change impacts, right? What is that report called as? There's a name given to the report, which go to the governments. What is the name of the report? It's called assessment report, AR, right? IPCC so far has brought 5 assessment reports, 5 AR has been brought, which is a comprehensive report, which talks about every aspect of climate and climate change and all the impacts. It also has a prediction part of it. What has happened in the past, what is happening present, and what will happen in future. They brought in AR, assessment report. Now, generally when you read current affairs, you'll come across reference spatial report, like 1.5 degrees Celsius, like land use, then polar and cryosphere. Their spatial report brought by the IPCC, but they are not AR. Assessment report is a final report prepared by the IPCC, which is goes every aspect of the climate change. And assessment report is brought in the gap of 5 to 6 years. It takes time, it is not happens every year. Now the new AR6 will be published very soon by the IPCC. In just next year, it will come, new report will come. Hey, 5 report abhi tak aa chuka hai. 5 reports so far has been published. The special reports are separate, they are different theme, right? So IPCC has created awareness and also action by the government to fight climate change. So you should also be prepared with the IPCC. Let's say if UPSC asks question where you have a reference to IPCC, you should be aware what is IPCC all about. Now my question to the classroom is that, is IPCC a scientific body? Can we call IPCC a scientific organization? Right, I mentioned what is IPCC, what is the objective. Can we call it as a scientific organization? No. IPCC is not a scientific organization. What do you mean by scientific organization, institution? Which is made of scientists, group of scientists, researchers, who conduct field study, collect the data, write a report, That is called scientific organization. IPCC simple compile the data. Right? IPCC doesn't have its own team of scientists doing all this one. What IPCC generally do? All the scientists worldwide, thousands of scientists who work on different areas of climate, their reports, their findings. IPCC take those kind of reports and there's something called working group. And IPCC has what? Working group. Who are the working groups? Working group still contains scientists. They're expert. They all look into the data, all the findings, and based on that bring a comprehensive report. Now another thing you have to remember. Politicians, when you take politicians, politicians don't understand the language of the scientific aspect of climate change. And scientists don't understand the language of politician. There's a gap there, right? If a politician, if you ask climate change, let's say you talk about Donald Trump, right? And ask him climate change, he will not be very happy to explain you the thing of that, right? Or you take any world leader, right? And if you ask a scientist, a core, very hardcore scientist, that about the, you know, development, social issues, problems, again, the person will not be that much of concerned with that. Because the scientists do only the research in the lab, or conduct field study, collect the data, publish a paper. So there is a gap between scientific community and gap between the political community. So what IPCC does, act as a bridge, right? What is IPCC? It's a bridge between the politicians, policymakers, and the scientists. Try to fill up the gap so that they understand each other. There should not be any miscommunication. A scientist should understand the impact and link with the socioeconomic aspect, and a politician with the socioeconomic aspect should understand the science behind the climate change. That's what IPCC does. Okay? Now let me just bring two more aspects of IPCC. One is that IPCC was awarded Nobel Peace Prize, right, 2007, for its groundbreaking work on the reports. Today worldwide, right, everybody knows what is global warming, what is climate change. It happened because of the work of the IPCC. So 2007, when the award was given, half of the prize money was given to the organization IPCC, and half of the prize was given to Al Gore. US Vice President Al Gore, he got the half of the prize. And as an individual person, being a politician, who is an American politician, has helped spread the words worldwide about the climate change. Though you know the America's policy on climate change is very different. And the organization got the prize, right? Second thing about IPCC is that whatever report IPCC brings about, it goes to very important convention called UNFCCC, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, which help the develop action plan globally to fight climate change. So this kind of report help in taking any kind of policy measure worldwide under the Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC, right? Now let's come to this one. So I've given there intergovernmental panel. I mentioned about WPO, WMO and part of it. Now these are the type of report, timeline. Let me just bring the timeline here. So let me just explain here. I'll just tell you one by one. See, when IPCC was formed in 1988, just in next 2 years, 1990, IPCC brought the first report, AR1, that was published in 1990. So if you can see here, I'll just come back to this. The jointly formed WMO and UNEP in 1988, right? Now the first report, 1990. Just in 2 years, it brought there. And this report, the first report, right, played an important role in terms of bringing the Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC, in the year 1992 during Rio Earth Summit, or what is also called popularly UN Conference on Environment and Development, which was held in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, right, Rio Earth Conference. So what played an important role in terms of taking the convention? That was the first report, AR1, what you have on the slide. Right. Now, when the Climate Change Convention was brought by the UN, so what happened generally with the convention? The governments join, or what we call signature, signing the convention. Then comes what? Acceptance, ratification. So it took around 2 years for the convention to be ratified. Right. For ratification, it requires some number of countries, maybe 30 countries, maybe 50 countries. The Climate Change Convention required 50 countries to ratify. Right, India also was one of the very important country during the Rio conference. So our country also signed the convention and we also ratified it. That means India is a member party of the convention. Right. So when the convention was brought into implementation after ratification, the objective of the convention, which have to be fulfilled worldwide by different countries who became party to that, it was just in the beginning phase, you can say nascent phase. What action has to be there? What should be the scientific basis on that? That was brought by IPCC with the second report, AR2, which came in the year 1995. You can see here, this 1995, this second report was there. Right, this you'll find the timeline, the 1995. And that in 1997, Kyoto Protocol was brought. So I'm now describing you the background, what exactly evolved. Kyoto Protocol is a landmark protocol, legally binding agreement, brought under UNFCCC, which basically asked the developed industrialized countries to cut down the carbon emission and given the targets. So the Kyoto Protocol, the every aspect of the Kyoto Protocol, at the back of the, you can say back the curtain, IPCC was working. And this report, second report, became a important point for the Kyoto Protocol to be drafted and then implemented, right? Now, Kyoto Protocol, 1997 in Japan, which was brought, again went for signing, ratification. And it took 7 to 8 years. Like 2005, it got ratified. 97 it was brought, and it took around 2005 for Kyoto Protocol to be implemented. Such a long time, 8 years time was taken. What was the concern there? The concern was that it only binds the annex one country. What is annex one country as per Kyoto Protocol? These are developed industrialized countries to cut down emission. Not the non-annex one country. Non-annex one country are developing countries like India, China, that they belong to non-annex one country. So it took a long time for ratification. Right? 2005 when Kyoto got ratified. So from 2006 onward, government started thinking of implementing the Kyoto Protocol, the targets given under Kyoto Protocol. So now comes the new report called 2001 report. You can see there is also one report, 2001, which played in the role of ratification Kyoto Protocol. And then 2007, right, you find fourth report, the same year when Nobel Prize was given to IPCC, right? Now things have changed over the time. Kyoto Protocol has not ended. This year, 2020, is the last year of Kyoto Protocol. After this year, 2020, Kyoto will end. And this will give way to Paris Agreement. 2021 will be the starting year of Paris Agreement, which came in 2015, during Paris Summit, what you call COP21, Conference of Parties 21st, of the Convention. Now, before Paris Summit, IPCC brought the fifth report in the 2013-14, that's called AR5. You can see in the diagram also AR5 is given there. And that helped in making the Paris Agreement. We'll see in today's class, what is the difference between Kyoto and Paris? I will be coming to that. But I'm just giving you the background, okay, how the IPCC became important, how the reports are important. So all these reports has helped evolve the convention, the protocol, agreement. Right? Now let's come to this particular one. Let me come across this one. Organization structure. IPCC has this working group. You have working group 1, physical science basis. Working group 2, climate change impact, adaptation and vulnerability grouping. Working group 3, mitigation of climate change. And the task force on national greenhouse gas inventory. Every country has to submit how much emission, what is the profile of the emission to the UNFCCC. And what IPCC does, it keeps a track. Let's say India, agriculture, industry, transport, energy, how much greenhouse gases we produce, how much the carbon emission takes place. All the inventory, the IPCC has a record of that. So is true with China, Japan, USA, you take any country. So that's also the role of IPCC. So that's what said, IPCC work with working group, which look into all the data, everything, and come out with the publication. Right? Now let's come to this part. There's a, recently, 3 reports have been brought, special report. The first report is global warming at 1.5°C. Now, why the title has been given 1.5 degrees Celsius? Because during Paris Summit 2015 in France, governments agreed to limit the Earth temperature by up to 1.5. The convention says that by the end of the century, by end of 2100, the Earth's temperature should not go more than 2 degrees Celsius. Right? That is the convention's document. But then the government decided to limit to 1.5. Abhi tak kitna rise ho chuka temperature? 1.1. If you take the beginning of Industrial Revolution, now here in this case 1860, and if you do a calculation up to the present time, the average temperature or surface has gone by 1.1. So 1.5 is just nearby, right? It's just the nearby. If we don't stop the carbon emission, the 1.5 we can easily reach in the next 10 or 20 years. It can easily be reached. And 2 degrees Celsius. And we are thinking of end of the century, right? It may happen by 2040 or 2035. The world can reach up to 2 degrees Celsius. And now you see that with the 1.1 degrees Celsius, there's so much of impact. Recently there was one, you know, very unique name, bomb. You know, bomb. What was bomb? How many of you know there's a name bomb? The name given bomb. Hurricane, tornado, cyclones are given names. Right? That was impacted in the America side. Like typhoon. That bomb was name given, right? In India, you know that Oki, Bangladesh, India, you know, there was a cyclone was there. So all these are there in the news. Then recently wildfire in Australia, Australian wildfire, southeast of Australia or New Wales, Australia. Like Australia has been facing wildfire for a long time, but this time was extreme wildfire, which killed more than a billion animals in that because of the wildfire, right? So that's what I'm saying, that with 1.1, already there are a lot of impacts, right? 1.5 will have more higher impacts, and 2 and beyond 2 will have catastrophic, what is called doomsday, right? So what IPCC did, brought a report, a special report, telling what will happen with 1.5 and what will happen if we exceed 1.5, right? And who will look into this part? The governments, so that they can take action on that to cut down the carbon emission. Second special report, what you have, climate change and the land. Summary for policymakers. How the climate change impact agriculture, forest, any kind of terrestrial ecosystem, right? Land use pattern, which may be affected because of the drought, flood, or even coastal area, there is also land, which gets submerged because of the coastal flooding or sea level rise. All these have been now brought. And I'll bring one more area, you are aware, desertification, land degradation and desertification, where the fertile land becoming a barren land. Again, because of what? Rising temperature, global warming, climate change. This is another special report. And the third report is very unique one. This is called Ocean and Cryosphere in a Changing Climate. What do you mean by cryosphere? Cryosphere. What is that cryosphere? We have three poles. What are three poles? One is Arctic, North Pole. Second is Antarctic, South Pole. And third is the mountain glaciers. I'm using the word mountain glaciers. Right, and the biggest one is Himalayan. But there are other mountains with their glaciers. Like Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa. Alps. Where is the Alps you have? France and all this one. So there are mountain glaciers. They're called third pole of the earth. Right? So what is happening now? As the warming will be there, as the temperature will rise, the snow will melt, ice will melt, and there is rapid melting. Arctic is melting very fast. What is Arctic? Arctic is not a continent. It's not a continent, not a land mass. Arctic is just a sea and ocean with floating mass of ice. If the water will become warm, all the ice will melt and break apart. Right? This is what is happening in Arctic. But when you say Antarctica, Antarctica is a continent, is a land mass. Even there also big chunk of ice is breaking apart, going to the Antarctic Sea. And what will happen? When all those ice will melt, all this will fall into the sea and ocean, there will be rise of sea level. What is called SLR, sea level rise. Melting of glacier will also accelerate the rising sea level. Right? So that is what the report comes. All these 3 years special reports. And important for 2020 pre-exam, because any of the finding on the report can be your question in the exam. Even UPSC can ask you direct question. ठीक है तो ये पढ़ के रखना होगा क्वेश्चन डायरेक्ट आ सकता है एग्जाम में इसे दैट्स व्हाट आई एम ब्रिंगिंग इन द क्लासरूम हियर नाउ लेट्स लुक एट हियर अनदर एस्पेक्ट ऑन दिस आई विल जस्ट टू कम टू दिस सो ग्लोबल वार्मिंग नाउ लेट्स कम टू सम बेसिक कंसेप्ट लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड सम बेसिक एस्पेक्ट ऑफ दैट आई हैव गिवन यू बैकग्राउंड व्हाट इज आईपीसीसी आईपीसीसी रिपोर्ट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग वर्ल्ड वाइड दिस जस्ट अ काइंड ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शन नाउ वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक कंसेप्ट राइट Now, basic concept here, the first thing what you see here, this graph, right? So, if you see, take year 1890, and then go up to 2000, you can see some kind of peaks are there. This peak is basically the emission at the same time temperature. And now what has happened, the carbon emission has gone to higher level. As per the report says that, the total global carbon emission has exceeded 400 ppm, 400 parts per million. So when we say carbon emission, it includes all the greenhouse gases, right? Carbon dioxide gas, methane, then you have chlorofluorocarbon, hydrofluorocarbon, perfluorocarbon, right? Ozone, you take any example. So it has already picked up more than 400 ppm. What I said, 1.1 degrees Celsius rise has been there. Now my question to the class, what do you mean by greenhouse effect? What's the meaning of the term greenhouse effect? What is the meaning of that? What is the concept of greenhouse effect? Okay. Okay. See, the three terms are there which are interconnected. Greenhouse effect, global warming, climate change. The three terms are there. They're interconnected with each other. Very simple understanding, greenhouse effect is basically trapping of Earth's heat, right, the radiation, the trapping of heat of the Earth, right, by greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, which do not allow the long wavelength infrared to penetrate and go to outer space. So what will happen? All this long infrared radiation, IR, will return back. It will just bounce back. So slowly what will happen? The Earth will again absorb radiation, will become more heated, warmed. And when the Earth, land and water will become more heat, will again release more infrared. So that will also go to the again to the atmosphere. And if you have rising concentration of carbon or greenhouse gases, let's say imagine that human beings continuously is emitting carbon emission. Greenhouse gases are building up in the atmosphere. And what is happening because of the greenhouse effect? Warming is taking place. The radiation, infrared, which goes up and again come back. And imagine that now the concentration keep on multiplying. So what will happen there? Earth will become more and more warm, right? When the Earth become more warm, more infrared. Again coming back, more warm. There's something called tipping point. Many times you'll read the word tipping point. What is tipping point? Tipping point is that temperature of the Earth's surface where Earth itself will become so hot. Right, Earth itself will become so hot, even though you have a greenhouse gas in the atmosphere, Earth will create a cascade of events, the warming part of it. Just like, you know, you have seen the hot iron ball, when you heat everything. That's called tipping point. And that tipping point is 2 to 3 degrees Celsius. Scientists have done calculation. So what I'm saying, greenhouse effect is what? Trapping of the heat, which comes back, and the Earth becomes warm. Now, what is the global warming? Global warming is steady. Right, continuous rise of the average temperature of Earth's surface, right, where the temperature of the Earth's surface on an average keep on rising. That is called global warming. Now, what is climate? How do you define climate? In geography, there's all linked with geographical aspect. So, what is climate? What do you mean by climate? Climate is a long term, which include precipitation, temperature range, right? These all are the parameters which determine the climate of a region, right? But when you say weather, weather also include light, temperature, rainfall, but it's a short-term kind of thing. It's a very simple thing. It's a very simple analogy I'll give you there. Let's say your wardrobe So people who live in Mumbai, in their wardrobe, what do you find there? In the almirah, in the wardrobe, you will have the light cloth, right? You will not find woolen cloth, sweater, jackets, you will not find. Again, what do you find for the Mumbaikar? They will carry the raincoat, you have an umbrella. So that wardrobe of a Mumbaikar represents a climate of Mumbai. See what type of cloth you will wear, what will you wear there, right? And the cloth what you are wearing right now, let's say in Pune, that represents the weather of today. See whether it's cold or warm, or whether it's going to be rainy season, that's good weather. So when we say climate, we are referring to long-term impact. And when we say climate change, the word change, so what does that mean? Changes in the climatic parameters or climatic conditions over a long period. That is called climate change. So what is happening there? Because of greenhouse effect, tapping of the heat, earth is becoming more and more warmer, that's called global warming. And because of global warming, temperature, pressure, wind pattern, ocean circulation, current, all these are changing. That is called climate change. That's the three terms which I've explained. They are interconnected to each other, right? So that's what you have to understand first go. When you come to climate change aspect, first you have to understand the terminology, the meaning of the word, right? So I have given here, this is what suggests there. Climate change, as the name suggests, refer to changes in global climate, result from increasing average global temperature, right? Now let's come to this one. Now question comes, a very interesting question. Is global warming natural or anthropogenic? Right. This is again question. And there are people who are called denial, climate change denial, who says that there is no climate change. It's all being created by scientists and this one. There's no climate change. Earth has been facing climate change for a long time. It's also correct because 10,000 years back, right, there was also a human. It's not that a human being, present the modern man is already facing the global warming climate change. Our ancestors, they've also faced global warming. They also faced the climate change, right? So when you say climate change, it's both natural and anthropogenic. Like let's say volcano, right? Let's say for example, bushfire, wildfire. What happened in Australia? Because of the wildfire, because of that event, burning of the forest. And when you burn any biomass, what it generates? Carbon dioxide gas. Recently it has come in the news that NASA, you know, NASA, the American Space Agency, has done the measurement and said that there have been 250 million tons of carbon emission because of burning in Australia. Bushfire ke karan 250 million se jyada to aise carbon emission ho gaya. Theek hai? So again, there is a, you know, cyclic event which happens there. Right? So this is what is happening. So both natural can be there. Volcanic eruption or wildfire, they are natural events. And anthropogenic is what? Vehicular pollution, the car, hydrocarbon what we burn. Another thing, what is the demand? Power, electricity. And today, worldwide thermal power station, burning of fossil fuel, coal, natural gas, these are anthropogenic, right? Farming, agriculture. How the farming result into carbon emission? Agriculture. When we use fertilizers, nitrogenous fertilizers, the soil emits nitrous oxide, N2O, which is called laughing gas, is another greenhouse gas, right? Soil also has a carbon, organic carbon, and is also because of bacterial decomposition or from the some kind of event there may also release carbon, right? When we deforest, when we do the mining, deforestation, again releases the carbon to the environment. So there can be many activities, not that only vehicles or power plant. There can be many human-based activities which can contribute to greenhouse gas. Whether it's the carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, you take any example, right? So it's both other. 97% agree that humans are the cause of global warming. So mostly it's from the anthropogenic change. Though natural also contribute, event also contribute. Now rise in this one, what I mentioned. How much has been rise? 1.1 degrees Celsius. I have put across on the slide here. So 16 out of 17 warmest years since 1900 happened after 2001. Every year is the hotter than the previous year. Okay. Last year, kya hua Europe mein? Last year, Europe mein heat wave. Okay. Europeans were like impacted by the heat wave event. Okay. And this summer, now the summer will come there, right? Just on the corner. है ना, नॉकिंग देयर. नेक्स्ट टू मंथ्स उसके बाद समर स्टार्ट होगा, मार्च अप्रैल. इट विल बी इवन मोर हॉटर देन द लास्ट समर. दिस ऑल द रिकॉर्ड्स हैव कम टू दैट. एंड देन इट सेज दैट ओशंस हैव एब्जॉर्ब द बल्क ऑफ द हीट. इफ लेट्स से एटमॉस्फेयर गेट्स हीटेड अप, तो वेयर द हीट विल बी गो, द सिंक. ओशन विल एब्जॉर्ब. When the ocean will absorb the heat, the ocean water will become more warm, right? This is what is happening over the past 10 years from the climate change point of view. Now rising sea level, this is the information. If you see the graph here, so what does the graph says? I'll just show you that this graph is there. Is it decreasing anywhere? It's not. It's just plateauing out, but again increasing. See, if you compare the sea level from 1870 and then goes up to 1990. There's been continuous rising of sea level. Now, there are two factors are there. One is the melting of glaciers or polar ice, where the large bulk of the water goes to the ocean. Second is what? Second, very important, is the because of the ocean which absorb the bulk of the heat. So there's something called thermal expansion. You know, water will expand, or any solid will also expand. It will become warm. So even the expansion of the ocean water because of warming of ocean water also lead to the SLR, sea level rise, right? And you can see here this one, global sea level rose by 20 centimeter. Kitna hota 20 centimeter? Kitna hoga batao? Agar hum centimeter ki baat kare, kitna 1 feet kitne centimeter barabar hota hai? 30 centimeter ke aas paas hai. To 1 feet, एक इंसान 5.5 फीट का 6 फीट का हो सकता है. ये बहुत मैटर करता है अगर इतना भी राइज हो गया. और किसके लिए ज़्यादा मैटर करता है? अगर इतना भी राइज हो गया, लो लाइंग कोस्टल एरियाज, ठीक है, अ कंट्री लाइक फिजी, बांग्लादेश, मालदीव, टुवालू, राइट, मॉरिशस, लक्षद्वीप इन इंडिया, अंडमान निकोबार. बट इट इज़ ए कंट्री, स्मॉल आइलैंड कंट्री. एक वर्ड आता है सीड्स, SIDS, स्मॉल आइलैंड डेवलपिंग स्टेट्स. उसमें फिजी का नाम आता है. वेर इज फिजी? पैसिफिक ओशन. इज एन आइलैंड, स्मॉल आइलैंड, राइट? इज अ वेरी रॉकी आइलैंड, बट अगेन इज जस्ट ऑन द सी. मालदीव्स, इट इज अ मालदीव, आवर नेबरिंग स्टेट इज देयर. मालदीव्स इज ऑन द सी. 20 सेंटीमीटर मीन्स मेनी पार्ट ऑफ द कोस्टल एरिया ऑफ मालदीव और फिजी विल बी सबमर्ज्ड. एंड वट वेयर द इम्पैक्ट विल बी देयर? इम्पैक्ट ऑन कोस्टल एग्रीकल्चर, फिशरीज, एंड इवन ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट. अब यहाँ एक वर्ड आता है, क्लाइमेट रेफ्यूजी. कई बार ये वर्ड आप पढ़ते हो, क्लाइमेट रेफ्यूजी. अभी बहुत सारे इंटरेस्टिंग चीज़ें मैं बताऊँगा, अभी सारे वन बाई वन आई एम कमिंग टू दैट. क्लाइमेट रेफ्यूजी इज अ रॉन्ग वर्ड. वाई इज अ रॉन्ग वर्ड? दो मोस्ट ऑफ द करेंट अफेयर्स दे यूज द रेफ्यूजी, दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ रेफ्यूजी. सही वर्ड नहीं है रेफ्यूजी, इज नॉट अ राइट वर्ड. क्या होता है रेफ्यूजी? क्या होता है? वट इज रेफ्यूजी? ऑल दिस अभी डिबेट है ना, अभी हॉट टॉपिक चल रहा है. रेफ्यूजी, वट इज रेफ्यूजी? हु इज अ रेफ्यूजी? दे माइग्रेट, है ना, दे लीव देयर ओरिजिनल प्लेस. मे बी एथनिक वायलेंस, राइट, मे बी सम काइंड ऑफ वॉर. दिज आर द, एंड विच कन्वेंशन डिफाइन रेफ्यूजी? दिस इज 1951 कन्वेंशन विच इंडिया हैज़ नॉट साइंड, राइट? ये भी पता है इंडिया इज नॉट अ सिग्नेटरी टू द UN Convention of Refugee, the Refugee Convention there. India is not a signatory. They define what is a refugee. Nowhere in convention, international convention, climate change refugee word is there. Kahi nahi hai. Is it the wrong word to use, climate change refugee? We can say climate change migrant. See, migration kya hota hai? Migration can be voluntary as well as involuntary, forced. राइट, फोर्स्ड माइग्रेशन. रेफ्यूजी क्या होता है? द फोर्स्ड माइग्रेंट्स हु आर फोर्स्ड बिकॉज ऑफ सम कंडीशन, हालात के कारण वो फोर्स होता है. लेकिन कई बार माइग्रेशन क्या होता है? वॉलंटरी होता है. लाइक फॉर वीज़ा, यू टेक वीज़ा एंड पासपोर्ट, विद पासपोर्ट वीज़ा यू गो फॉर हायर स्टडी, इज माइग्रेशन. समटाइम पीपल फॉर जॉब गो टू द दुबई और USA और यूरोप फॉर एम्प्लॉयमेंट, इज ऑल्सो माइग्रेशन. सो वट इज द करेक्ट वर्ड? क्लाइमेट चेंज माइग्रेंट. Because of induced, because of climate change and disaster, they are forced to go into that. So even though today worldwide, under legal term, under law term, under the convention, climate change refugee is still a new word. It's being now defined. कि क्या उसको हम refugee में डालेंगे कि नहीं डालेंगे? There's already being work being done. You can say they are displaced people, climate change displaced, or migrant because of the impact of climate change. Do we have such people in India? Do we have such people? Because of climate change, they are migrating. Migration can be inside also and outside country also. Right? Where we have such kind of climate migrant, climate change migrant? Sundarbans. Okay. Anything else? I'll give you one very good example, Rajasthan. A very best example, Rajasthan. If you come to Delhi, Delhi, many of the Rajasthanis, they have left their home in their villages. For their earning, they have come to Delhi. And they work as a sometime laborer also. Why they were forced? Because the land has become infertile, drought, arid land. They cannot grow crop, they cannot have food. So they are forced to migrate. I'm talking about very small level. Fiji and the big thing is something else. Second, Sundarban, Sundarban Delta. There are certain islands in Sundarban which are sinking. They're going underwater. Andar ja raha, pani ke niche ja raha hai. Ek island tha, New Moor Island. It's gone underwater. Ab bacha hi nahi. Right, recently one article came about a Lakshadweep island called Bagram. This is called atoll. Lakshadweep is made of atoll. Andar ja gaya, lekin wo human nahi hai. Imagine if Kavarati, Minicoy, Agati, where you have human settlement and that sinks. Very migrant. So migration is a very big thing what is happening there. Now what is the voice being raised? Let those climate change induced disaster or extreme event impacted people, they should be also recognized with their rights. And they can be given. And the number is increasing. It is not a small number. Worldwide climate migrants are increasing very fast. Yeh bada concern hone wala hai. Ek to hai ki war ya affected area hai, unko hum sambhalein. अब बाद में आने वाले टाइम में क्या होगा, सारे क्लाइमेट माइग्रेंट वगैरह जाएंगे, उनको संभालना होगा. और ये रियलिटी है, इज गोइंग टू बी देयर, राइट? तो दैट्स व्हाट आई वांट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड कि व्हेन यू रीड सच काइंड ऑफ थिंग, क्लाइमेट चेंज रिपोर्ट, यू शुड ऑलवेज एनालाइज. एंड वेट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, मेन एग्जाम. सो नाउ आई विल कम टू दिस राइजिंग सी लेवल. नाउ सी राइज ऑफ एक्सट्रीम वेदर इवेंट. व्हाट आर एक्सट्रीम वेदर इवेंट? आई हैव मेंशन सो मेनी नेम्स, साइक्लोन, हरिकेन, टोर्नेडो, then heat waves, all these are extreme event, flood, drought, famine, right? And I have used one very important word, ocean acidification. Acidification. Now who will tell me, what do you mean by ocean acidification? Ocean is a carbon sink, it's a natural carbon sink. When there will be more CO2 gas in the atmosphere, ocean will absorb more. So what will happen there? Carbonate and bicarbonate. Dissolve carbon dioxide with water. Right? Sodium carbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, all those things. That will increase in the water, ocean water. And ocean water will become more and more acidified. Now tell me, if ocean become acidified, what impacts will be there? Food web, marine food web. Phytoplankton. Phytoplanktons are the producers of marine food web. They will get impacted. Coral reef, coral bleaching, the loss of the algae from the coral, symbiotic algae, and death of the coral. If coral reef dies, coral reef is gone, the entire marine ecosystem is gone. This is what the impact ocean acidification had, right? Then come into here, this one, greenhouse gases. Sometimes in the question paper, they also ask the direct names of the greenhouse gases. So you should not think only carbon dioxide, methane. There are number of gases are there. And they all come under Kyoto Protocol. Right? So you have the list of that. Methane, nitrous oxide, and part of it. Now, I'll ask one question. Let me see how many of you know that. Global warming potential, GWP. These are the list of greenhouse gases. So what do you mean by the term global warming potential? Carrying capacity. Carrying capacity, okay. Anything else? Global warming potential.
So it defined with respect to carbon dioxide.
Okay. If we take CO2, carbon dioxide gas, 1 ton of carbon dioxide gas, and we take a time period of 10 years, 50 years, or 100 years, whichever we want to compare, 10 years time period, or a 50 years, 50, or 100 years. And we take 1 ton of CO2 gas, and we take 1 ton of methane gas, and compare how much warming is there. So what we'll find, methane will cause more warming than carbon dioxide. Methane has got something around 20 times more warming than CO2 gas. Same amount is 1 ton. And if you take same time period, 10 years, methane will cause more warming. And if you take CFC, HFC, chlorofluorocarbon, hydrofluorocarbon, they'll cause 1,000 times more warming. HFC is very dangerous. Today we use hydrofluorocarbon in place CFC, is very dangerous gas. It can create more warming, 14,000 times more warming than what CO2 gas can do. So another thing is what? When you read about global warming, climate change, you should not only know the names of the gases, sources of the gases, impact of the gas, but again the potential, how much warming they have. Kuch aise gases hain jo long term nahi rehta hai climate mein. Ek word aur aayega, bahut important word mein concept samjha raha hu main, short lived climate pollutant, SLCP kehte hain usko. Carbon dioxide long lived hai. Agar hum 1 ton CO2 ko emit kar diya to CO2 wahin par rahega, wo khatam nahi hone wala hai. Some natural event will absorb, what you know, carbon cycle will take up there, but it persists for a longer time. But there are certain type of gases which are very short lived, very small thing. Which are these? Methane, water vapor, right? Black carbon, there is another called black carbon, unburned carbon, ozone. Konsa ozone ki baat ho rahi hai? Stratosphere ki baat nahi ho rahi hai, ground level ozone. Ye short lived hota hai, but they are greenhouse gas. It causes warming, right? So, ये सब चीजों को ध्यान रखना है, which I have given here. Now, main greenhouse gas में सबसे ज़्यादा ये चीज़ है. तीन main greenhouse gas है. 82% generation worldwide is carbon dioxide. Second comes 9% methane, and then comes 6% nitrous oxide. बाकी सब remaining कम है. तो thankfully, HFC amount is not very high. That's the thing. Thankfully, it is not emitted more than that. अगर वो ज़्यादा होता है तो और खतरनाक होता है. ठीक है, ये परसेंटेज है कार्बन का. और कहाँ ज़्यादा सोर्स है, ये चीज़ है. सबसे ज़्यादा सोर्स कहाँ आता था? इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेशन, पावर जनरेशन. सेकंड कहाँ से आता है? ट्रांसपोर्ट सेक्टर में जो है. देन कम्स फॉर इंडस्ट्री एंड द हाउसेज, रेजिडेंशियल एरिया, CO2 गैस एमिशन. वर्ल्ड वाइड हाइएस्ट जनरेशन ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज फ्रॉम, नॉट फ्रॉम इंडस्ट्री. है ना, लोग सोचते इंडस्ट्री, इंडस्ट्रियल एमिशन होता है, लेकिन पावर जनरेशन इज मोर, थर्मल पावर प्लांट. एंड इज नॉट ओनली इंडिया, चाइना, डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज, यू ऑल यूज फॉर पावर जनरेशन एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सेगमेंट. इंडस्ट्री कम्स अ थर्ड, एंड वी पीपल एट डोमेस्टिक लेवल आर फोर्थ लेवल, राइट? सो दैट इज वॉट यू हैव हियर. एंड वाटर वेपर एंड ऑल, यू नो नाउ जस्ट वॉट आई एक्सप्लेन इन द क्लासरूम, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग पोटेंशियल. वॉट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर फॉर UPSC एग्जाम, दिस ऑल वैल्यूज, ये आपको याद होना चाहिए. और ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, लास्ट ईयर प्री एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आया हुआ है, मीथेन पे पूछा गया था. मीथेन जो है आफ्टर 10 इयर्स गेट कन्वर्ट इनटू, ऑक्सीडाइज इनटू कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड और सम अदर फॉर्म. सो मीथेन इज नॉट अ लॉन्ग टर्म लॉन्ग लिव्ड कार्बन पोल्यूटेंट, राइट? सो 25 टाइम्स. नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड कॉज इट अराउंड 300 टाइम्स, यू हैव 298 टाइम्स. HFC कॉज 14,800, राइट? दिस हैज टू बी एट द बैक ऑफ द माइंड, कि वॉट इज ग्लोबल वार्मिंग पोटेंशियल, राइट? सो आई हैव गिवन हियर द सल्फर हेक्साफ्लोराइड इज अनदर गैस देयर, एंड आई हैव मेंशन द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज अ मोर जनरेशन ऑफ देम. नाउ कंट्री वाइज इफ यू सी, नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड कंट्री प्रोफाइल, यू कैन मेक इट आउट फ्रॉम द फिगर. द बिगेस्ट बलून इज USA, चाइना इज ऑल्सो नॉट फार अवे, राइट? इफ यू सी हियर, यू जस्ट सी हियर द USA, राइट? देन यू फाइंड हियर ऑस्ट्रेलिया, another country, Belgium, Germany, United Kingdom, right? Italy, France, Sweden, Portugal, Mexico, China, India. Now if you take about total, like, tons of equivalent carbon per capita, is a per capita emission. What is per capita? Each person. In that case, India, China comes lower level. Because in American, each of the American emit more carbon. That's per capita means, take based on the population. Though India has a huge population, we have more population than America's. America's ज़्यादा population है, Link per capita emission kam hai, kyun? How would you explain that? Ye concept kaun samjhayega? Though India's population is much higher, USA has a population wahan bhi zyada hai, lekin per capita kaise India ka kam hoga? Do cheeze hain. Very good. The two things are that how many people they emit carbon. ये भी matter करता है ना. कितने लोग emit कर रहे हैं ये भी तो है ना. अगर हम गांव में जाएं, rural area जाएं, तो हो सकता है कि उनका emission कम होगा, या zero होगा. They may live a lifestyle which may not burn the fossil fuel. ये भी हो सकता है. So if we take overall population, not all are releasing at a very high level. The degree is there. And why it is there? Because India is still mostly rural. ठीक है ना? Urban areas है. सुनने में लगता है पुणे, हैदराबाद, मुंबई, दिल्ली, है ना? Urbanization हो रहा है. That is. But we are not there. Still, where the maximum people live in the villages, rural area, small town, है ना? There that part. What can contribute from Indian side? Agriculture. That can be one side. But if you take industrialized countries, all these industrialized countries, they all have been industrialized and urbanized. So they are using AC, refrigerator, car, vehicle. So they are emitting more per day. ठीक है? अब मैं एक क्वेश्चन पूछता हूँ. अगर यही चीज़ को ग्रॉस में देखा जाए, total from a country, then where India will come? India will be after US, China, European Union, fourth. You take all the Europe, so first will become USA, overall, total amount, right? Per capita we may be small, right? Then again, gross mein, dono mein, America is both higher, per capita also, gross also. China, our neighbor, right, gross is very high. European countries and India will come fourth. That means, is a concern for us, ki we have to also fight climate change, because we are also releasing carbon from different sector of economy. That's one thing is that total comes into that. So different emission trend, I'll not go into that detail. Now look at here, per capita. So you can see the red one. What you see in the red one, they are the more emitting countries. India ka blue mein, right? We are at the moderate level there, right? We are not that much of that. Okay, now let's come to this one. I'm now coming to convention. Okay, before I give my answer, let me ask each one of you, what are the things you know about the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change? Kya kya points hain? Anyone in the classroom? Let me ask him, kya kya pata hai? Wo to maine slide mein de rakha hai. That part I'll come to later. Lekin, without looking, what are the things you know about Climate Change Convention? Earth Summit mein aaya tha, good, okay. Ye to background ho gaya. Conference of parties wo theek hai. Kya objective hai? What is the objective of the convention? Because I'm going to now write something, that's what I'll be coming to writing part also. But just I want to know how much you know about the convention. How many countries have joined and party to the convention? 197 countries are there. Right? You can say nearly universal. It's almost like a universal. And they're divided into three big groups. Which are the three big groups? One is called Annex I country, developed industrialized countries. Second is called Annex II country. Which are Annex II country? Annex II countries are not developing countries. These are those countries which are transition economy and they generally belong to OECD, Organization of Economic and Cooperation Development. And they also give support to the developing countries. India, China, Brazil comes into non-Annex I country. There are three big groups. Annex I, Annex II, non-Annex I. And now I have a point. LDC. What is LDC? Least Developed Countries. There are another group. It is called G77, group of 77 plus China. China also supports them. Right? There it comes there. So now let's come to this one. Here, 31st, I have said 2 years it took for ratification. 1994 it got ratified. Then objective. Stabilize the greenhouse gas emission in the upper atmosphere. Not let the greenhouse gas concentration rise to a level which can cause 2 degrees Celsius rise. That comes into. and there is no binding limit. Now see, very important thing is the part, there is no binding limit. What is the word here? Framework convention. UNFCCC, United Nations framework. So there is nothing called bindingness. Right? Guidelines. It just created a platform. Right? And then 2015, you know, Paris. So now let's understand here. I'll come to COP there, but first let me come back to the point here. So let me write here. When you say UNFCCC, let me just bring certain aspect on that. Let me just bring about something. First thing is that I'll just put in a flowchart here. There are some guiding principles on this. When the convention came, 1992. When it got implemented, 1994. Right, Rio Conference, Agenda 21, all this you are aware of it. Now I'm coming to guiding principles. On what principles does convention work? So kya principle? Maybe sara flowchart mein, I'll give you a now very important point. Then I'll come to the other aspect. Now tell me, what are the guiding principles of this convention? What is the first one? Very, very important. Ye sab pata hona chahiye. Historical responsibility. What do you mean by this term, historical responsibility? Today, climate change. The worldwide, the climate change threat, which has become an existential threat, climate emergency, has been because of the all the developed countries who started with the Industrial Revolution over the past 150, 200 years, they contributed. So who should be more responsible? Developed countries. Burden. Kisko burden jyada rehna chahiye? Developed countries ko. Kyun? Unhone kiya. Emission wahan par. Jo bolte hain carbon stock, jo stock wahan par hai. Jo produce kiya unhone. Aur abhi bhi kar rahe. They should be more responsible. Historical matlab yahi hai. Aitihasik ground pe. India kab start hua? India, Pakistan, Africa, ye sab jitne countries hain. Ye sab to abhi after Second World War. Second World War ke baad hi hua na. And agar bhi, agar usme bhi dekha jaye, इंडिया का जो ग्रोथ पाथ है तो पहले दो तीन डिकेड में कुछ नहीं है. अब हम बात कर रहे हैं ना, नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट देयर इज मोर एमिशन. 50 60 में कहाँ था इंडिया में, 70 में कहाँ था? नहीं था ना उस समय. अभी प्रॉब्लम है. सो दैट इज व्हाट आई से हिस्टोरिकल रिस्पॉन्स मीन्स दीज डेवलप्ड इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड कंट्रीज, दे आर हिस्टोरिकली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर टुडेज द प्रॉब्लम एंड दे शुड टेक मोर बर्डन ऑफ फाइटिंग क्लाइमेट चेंज. तो बर्डन क्या होगा? एडाप्टेशन, मिटिगेशन, fund, technology, they should bear. Now I'm writing second one, very important principle I'm writing here. What India, China, developing country talks about, CBDR. Common but differentiated responsibility. Kya iska matlab hai? Who will tell me what is the meaning of this word, CBDR? Let me first write this word there. Many times in newspaper, current affairs will come across the word CBDR. What do you mean by the word CBDR? एंड सेम है. एंड सेम क्या मतलब है? ऑल कंट्रीज हैव टू फाइट फॉर क्लाइमेट चेंज. व्हाई? इट्स अ ग्लोबल प्रॉब्लम. इट डजंट सी, क्लाइमेट चेंज डज नॉट डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन अ डेवलप्ड कंट्री और डेवलपिंग और अ पुअर कंट्री. इफ इंडिया इज इंपैक्टेड बाय क्लाइमेट साइक्लोन, सो इज फिजी एंड सो इज द यूएसए ऑल्सो. उनको इंपैक्ट है. सी लेवल राइज अगर इंडिया में हो रहा है तो सब जगह हो रहा है. तो प्रॉब्लम तो कॉमन है, फाइट भी करना कॉमन है, एंड भी कॉमन है, लेकिन जो मींस है वो एक नहीं हो सकता. क्यों नहीं हो सकता? एक हाँ, बिगज द कंडीशन, सोसाइटल कंडीशन, इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ, सोशियो इकोनॉमिक पैरामीटर्स आर नॉट द सेम फॉर ईच कंट्री. फिजी बेचारा छोटा सा कंट्री है, कहाँ से उसके पास टेक्नोलॉजी आएगा? फ्रॉम वेयर दे विल गेट द फाइनेंस? ठीक है, USA and Europe, Germany, they may have finance. But what about the small countries? They will not have. Bangladesh, kahan se karega? Nepal, from where they will get? Maldives. Hai na, ye cheez hai. Now third one, very important point I'm writing. The third guiding principle on this one is called loss and damage. It's a very, very important principle. You should be aware of that. L&D, loss and damage principle. Kya iska matlab hai? What do you mean by the word loss and damage? मॉनेटरी कंपनसेट करना है. कौन करेगा कंपनसेट? हु विल गिव द कंपनसेबल डैमेज? डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज. व्हाट अबाउट इंडिया, चाइना एंड ऑल डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज? हु आर द कल्प्रिट हियर? गुनहगार कौन कौन है? गुनहगार तो सभी है ना, है ना? गुनहगार तो सब है, सभी लोग एमिशन कर रहे हैं, है ना? इंडिया भी कर रहा है, चाइना भी कर रहा है, यूएसए भी कर रहा है, जापान भी कर रहा है, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, सब है वहाँ पर. अल्टीमेटली व्हाट इज लॉस एंड डैमेज इज वेरी डिफरेंट कंसेप्ट. लॉस एंड डैमेज कम्स विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू एओसिस और सिड्स, एस आई डी एस. व्हाट इज एओसिस स्टैंड फॉर? एसोसिएशन ऑफ द आइलैंड स्टेट्स, जो आइलैंड स्टेट्स होते हैं, या सिड्स जो स्मॉल आइलैंड डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, वो क्या कह रहे हैं कि वी आर फेसिंग द थ्रेट एवरी डे, हर दिन थ्रेट है वहाँ पर, एंड दे आर नॉट जनरेटिंग द ग्रीन हाउस गैस व्हाट द अदर कंट्रीज हैव डन. सो हु आर डिमांडिंग फॉर द कंपनसेशन इज नॉट द इंडिया और चाइना, इज बीन डिमांडेड बाय G77, ग्रुप ऑफ 77. तो वेयर द लॉस एंड डैमेज प्रिंसिपल कम्स, इट कम्स फॉर लीस्ट डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज. सो आई अगेन रिपीट हियर, historical responsibility is for developed countries. CVDR is for developing countries, who says that we cannot take the same burden because we have to also develop it. And loss and damage is for least developed countries, LDCs. Ab Paris summit jo hua tha, during Paris summit, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and Mr. Narendra Modi, and the Indian government, right? And it was in France there. So France and India brought another very important concept. I'll just give another very important principle called climate justice. अब justice की बात हो रही है, equity and justice. क्या है justice? कौन बताएगा justice का मतलब क्या है? न्याय. न्याय का मतलब क्या होता है? क्या होता है मतलब न्याय का मतलब क्या होता है? हाँ, फर्ज मनी को न्याय. What do you mean by न्याय? न्याय का मतलब क्या होता है? व्हाट इज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल न्याय, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल जस्टिस क्या होता है उसमें? हाँ, सो नाउ इफ यू हैव टू गो फॉर फेयर ट्रीटमेंट, इक्वालिटी फॉर एवरीवन, हाउ यू कैन रिलेट विद क्लाइमेट चेंज हियर? हाँ, हाउ यू कैन लिंक विद क्लाइमेट चेंज? हाँ, ठीक है, बहुत सिंपल सा कंसेप्ट है. इसको दो तीन तरह से समझना है. पहला है क्लाइमेट स्पेस, कार्बन स्पेस, है ना, स्पेस मिलना चाहिए. अब उसमें ये नहीं कह सकते कि नहीं यू स्टॉप एमिशन, राइट, एंड वी विल ओनली डू द एमिशन, यू शुड नॉट डू दैट. जबरदस्ती हो गया ना, तो फोर्स करना हो गया. तो व्हाट दिस डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज आर डूइंग, दे आर सेइंग दैट नो नो, वी हैव टू रन द इकोनॉमी, वी आर द लीडर्स, without our economy the world economy will not run. And वो दूसरों क्या बोलते हैं, कम करो, cut emission. They are the more consumers, they are more producers of the greenhouse gas, but they ask the others to do that. So that is the injustice. किसके injustice है? Small countries. ठीक है, एक तो ये angle है. दूसरा angle क्या है? When it comes to technology and finance, now let me bring a very important point. When it comes to technology and finance, it has to be equal footing. Now let's say, understand very important dynamic. What is very important dynamic? America. America क्या करता है? बहुत चालू है, very smart. उनको अगर support चाहिए किसी country का, नेपाल का या बांग्लादेश का या कोई भी country है, तो उनको finance करेगा, वो fund करेगा. Is you know one of type of kind of loyalty, कि how you bring the loyalty. अब वो क्या करेंगे, चलो ठीक है बांग्लादेश को, see सुंदरबन डेल्टा आपका डूब रहा है, यू आर फ्लडिंग एवरीथिंग, सो अमेरिका विल गिव ऑल द रिलीफ, ऑल द पैकेज, एवरीथिंग. सो बांग्लादेश लॉयल, माई बाप बहुत, वट एवर यू से दैन, राइट, ये चीज़ है, दैट इज थिंग ना, कि वेयर इट कम्स टू दैट काइंड ऑफ लॉबिंग. तो वॉट हैपन्स, द अदर कंट्री फिजी बेचारा, वी डोंट गेट एनी थिंग, वो हाथ खड़ा है कि पैसे मिले, कुछ मिले. अब फिजी को पैसा नहीं दिया जा रहा है, ठीक है, और दूसरे को दिया जा रहा है. So what is climate justice means? That when it comes to finance, to fight climate change, or if transferring technology, it should be based on the need and the equality. Should not be discriminated. Justice ka नहीं होता है जब हम डिस्क्रिमिनेशन करते हैं, लेकिन अन्याय तभी होता है ना, डिस्क्रिमिनेट करते हैं। तो यहाँ किसकी बात हो रही है? क्लाइमेट चेंज की बात हो रही है। वहाँ भी डिस्क्रिमिनेशन हो सकता है, हैव एंड हैव नॉट्स, दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ क्लाइमेट जस्टिस। ठीक है, इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म आई एम कवरिंग द क्लासरूम। ये इज ऑल एरिया वेयर यूपीएससी कैन आस्क क्वेश्चन। नाउ व्हाट आई एम कमिंग बैक टू द सेम फ्लो चार्ट। तो व्हाट आई हैव गिवन हियर, प्रिंसिपल्स, देन व्हाट कम्स हियर, ग्रुपिंग्स, ग्रुपिंग्स ऑफ द कंट्रीज, राइट? तो विच आर ग्रुपिंग फर्स्ट, अनेक्स वन है ना। हियर यू हैव ऑल डेवलप्ड इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड कंट्रीज इन वन फ्लो चार्ट। आई एम गिविंग यू ऑल द इंटायर समरी ऑफ द इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड कंट्रीज आर देयर, ग्रुप ऑफ यूरोपियन कंट्रीज, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, कनाडा, यूएसए, सारा वो उसमें आ जाता है। सेकेंड इज हियर अनेक्स टू कंट्री, दीज आर बेसिकली द ट्रांजिशन इकोनॉमी, देर ऑल्सो लाइक ट्रांजिशन एट द सेम टाइम देर ऑल्सो डेवलप कंट्रीज, देर नॉट डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, अगेन टेल यू देर ऑल्सो डेवलप कंट्रीज विच फाइनेंस डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, इट गिव्स द फाइनेंस टू डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, यू नो जापान, जापान गिव अस द फंड, समटाइम यूरोपियन कंट्री, जर्मनी, फ्रांस मे गिव सम फंड टू इंडिया, सो देयर इज अ, आई हैव यूज्ड द वर्ड ओईसीडी। देन व्हाट आई एम राइटिंग हियर, नॉन एनेक्स वन कंट्री, नाउ दिस इज डेवलपिंग कंट्री, वेन एवर यू कम अकॉस वर्ड नॉन एनेक्स वन कंट्री दे रेफर टू डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, सो इंडिया कम्स इन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर नॉन एनेक्स वन ग्रुप, द डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, राइट? देन कम्स व्हाट हियर, the LDCs, least developed countries, right? They are the small countries, right? They are called least developed countries. What I mentioned about G77, their groupings are there, right? Now they, what has come into recent time, what I am now coming here, another group which has come, SEEDS, small island developing states, है ना? तो हर जगह लॉबी होता है, अपना अपना ग्रुप बना के चलते हैं, एंड ऑल आर टॉकिंग अबाउट देयर ओन इंटरेस्ट, राइट? तो क्लाइमेट चेंज, साइंस ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज इज वेरी सर्टन कि देयर आर इंपैक्ट्स, बट एक्शन रिक्वायर्ड इज अनसर्टन, राइट? नाउ व्हाट आई एम कमिंग हियर, ऑब्जेक्टिव, राइट? व्हाट आर ऑब्जेक्टिव्स हियर? नाउ इफ यू हैव टू ब्रिंग द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द कन्वेंशंस, तो व्हाट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स विल बी देयर? व्हाट इज फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव? नाउ टेल मी फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव, नंबर वन, to limit temperature up to how much? 2 degrees Celsius, 1.5 has come in Paris. So here first one, to limit temperature below 2 degrees Celsius, that is the ultimate goal of the convention. And by which time? By 2100, end of the century. Ab kab hoga? When you cut down the carbon emission, stabilize the greenhouse gas, right? What is second objective? And I'll ask the question, that second objective is that adaptation, right? Adaptation and mitigation strategy. The convention talks about that countries should adopt adaptation and mitigation strategies. And third is that who will give the finance and the technology, clean technology? Developed countries. Annex one countries to non-annex one countries. So here, what is responsibility? Finance, climate change to fight the finance and technology based on historical responsibility by developed countries, not the developing countries. Developed countries are obliged to provide the fund, provide the clean technology, better technology to developing other countries. These are three objectives of the convention. Okay, now my question, very simple question. Because what happened, all the students keep on reading current affairs, keep on using the term, but they don't understand the meaning of the word. What is mitigation? What is adaptation? My simple question, I've written there, the convention talks about mitigation, adaptation strategies. So what do you mean by mitigation and what do you mean by adaptation?
Mitigation is a precaution.
Mitigation is a precaution, okay. Okay, decisions and planning. And what is adaptation then? adaptation. Which one? जब चेंज होता है अडॉप्ट होने के लिए ठीक है हैबिट एक्चुअल इंप्लीमेंटेशन एसिमिलेशन इन द चेंज पा जी क्या है वो अडॉप्टेशन राइट हाँ करेक्ट करेक्ट इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल थिंग The emission, the amount of carbon emission, the carbon stock, reducing that emission is a mitigation. Very simple word. How we can reduce the carbon emission, the greenhouse gas emission, that is mitigation. Because if greenhouse gas will come down, climate change impact will be less. You know, mitigation is what? Reducing the impact. And how the impact will reduce? If the carbon emission is less. And how carbon emission will be less? I'm using another very important word. When we can create more carbon sequestration, carbon capture. If we can capture carbon, sequester carbon, reduce the carbon emission, mitigation. Whether it's a transport, power generation, agriculture, tourism, industry, you take any example. But what is adaptation? Adaptation is not with respect to reducing there. Adaptation is a resilience. Resilience part of it. That means whatever the impact is there, how we can be resilient to that impact. ठीक है, sea level rise हो रहा है. अब sea level rise को कम करना है, तो mitigation क्या होगा? Mitigation ये होगा कि हमें carbon emission कम करना है. ताकि मेल्टिंग ऑफ ग्लेशियर वगैरह नहीं हो यही है और अडॉप्टेशन करना है तो क्या चाहिए कि जो फ्लडिंग हो रहा है इन दैट सिनेरियो हाउ वी कैन कैरी आउट एग्रीकल्चर इन द कोस्टल एरिया हाउ वी कैन लिव इन दैट फ्लडेड सिचुएशन बाय बिल्डिंग हाउस एंड होम हाउ वी कैन मेक होम और स्ट्रक्चर विच शुड बी रिजिलियंट टू साइक्लोन दैट इज कॉल्ड अडॉप्टेशन ये ना उसको अनुकूलन बोलते हैं अनुकूलित होना अडॉप्ट करना जो रियलिटी है उसके साथ अडॉप्ट करना क्योंकि कम होने में तो टाइम लगेगा मिटिगेशन तो लंबा समय लगेगा लेकिन जो हो रहा है उस पर तो हमें पहले अडॉप्ट करना है अगर वहाँ नहीं करेंगे तो एक्सटिंक्शन ये चीज़ है अडॉप्टेशन अब जैसे ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज सफरिंग विद वाइल्ड फायर एवरी ईयर बट सो फार द गवर्नमेंट हैज़ बीन वेरी नॉट वेरी वेरी एक्टिव उनका अडॉप्टेशन मेजर्स ही बहुत कम है अभी क्या हुआ बुश फायर में द फायर फाइटर ये है ना 29 पीपल डाइड इन द ऑस्ट्रेलियन बुश फायर क्लाइमेटी है ना वो तो क्लाइमेटी हो गया डिजास्टर हो गया तो वहाँ क्या होना चाहिए सफिशिएंट फायर फाइटर्स सफिशिएंट इक्विपमेंट ये सारी चीज़ होना चाहिए ये तो अडॉप्टेशन है ना वो नहीं था अगर अडॉप्टेशन होता है पहले से होता है हेलीकॉप्टर रेडी होता है विद ऑल द स्प्रेयर विच कैन पुट डाउन द फायर ये सब नहीं था जबकि ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज फेसिंग दिस प्रॉब्लम नॉट इज अ न्यू थिंग इज हैपनिंग फॉर द पास्ट सो मेनी ईयर्स ऑस्ट्रेलिया ऑलवेज हैव द वाइल्ड फायर्स ठीक है अब सी कोस्टल एरिया है तो वहाँ अडॉप्टेशन वही होगा कि वहाँ क्या मेजर होना चाहिए क्या टेक्नोलॉजी होना चाहिए कि वी कैन गेट प्रोटेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सी लेवल राइज दैट्स कॉल्ड अडॉप्टेशन राइट सो दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव गिवन दिस इज द व्हाट आई हैव ड्रॉन इन द फ्लो चार्ट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग टू रिमेंबर नाउ लेट मी कम टू दिस व्हाट आई एम नाउ कमिंग हियर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग व्हेन द कन्वेंशन हैज व्हाट कन्वेंशन हैज गॉट द कन्वेंशन हैज गॉट व्हाट इट हैज अ कॉप व्हाट डू यू मीन अ कॉप Conference. Anyone in the classroom who can make me understand the real meaning of COP. Is right that you have given the full form. COP is a conference of parties. But what is the meaning of COP? Kya exactly hota hai COP?
They are the member country.
So let me keep here. They are the member countries?
To participate.
To participate there. Anything else? COP has two meaning. Kya meaning hai? First, COP means is basically a governing body of the convention. When it's a conference of parties, it's basically a specialized governing body which look into every matter, every objective, every aspect of the convention. And when you come with number, COP21, COP25, which is France, ye Spain mein hua, COP25, so that number is the summit. where intergovernmental talk happens, where the government come and discuss the matter of the convention. So when we use the word conference of parties, it is a governing body. And second, when you have a number, that is a meeting or summit of the member states. So here, I have given here, the first COP was in Germany, 1995. 94, it got ratified. 95 in Berlin. Pehla COP was the COP1. Aur abhi last kahan hua hai? COP25? Madrid. Madrid city jo abhi Spain ka hai, wahan par hua hai. COP25 hua. Earlier it was planned for the Peru. Chile ka jo tha. Chile ka tha, to Chile ne mana kar diya. Haath khada kar diya ki how will we manage that. So then the venue was shifted to Madrid. Right? That is called COP. Now what comes here? These are the COP. Again, for your basic understanding, you don't have to remember for UPSC exam. COP 1 was in Germany, first conference. Then you have Geneva, COP 2. COP 3, 1997, Kyoto Protocol. That was COP 3, when Kyoto came into existence. Then if you take here, I'll just come to that. New Delhi. Now see here, very important thing I would like to highlight. 2002, COP 8. Delhi was the host. Why I brought this information? To let you know, even India has also been the host of UNFCCC. You should not think only the Madrid and Marrakesh or Paris. And we have done in 2002. You should know that if a question has come, whether India has hosted or not, or something has been given in the question. You should not think that India has not done it. India has also hosted. So you have a New Delhi here. Then, CMP, Conference of Member Parties. So Paris tak wahan par hai, CMA, let me come to this one. Kyoto Protocol and Paris Agreement, let's come to that part. Difference, kaun batayega? Difference between Kyoto Protocol 1997 and Paris Agreement 2015.
So Paris Agreement is extension of Kyoto Protocol. So Kyoto Protocol was the
मैंने इसलिए what I've done there, I have given you a compilation in the you have in your Telegram group also there. You have a compilation part, right? That I've already given. But again, why I'm discussing the classroom? I'm discussing the classroom to make you understand. The PowerPoint is the only means to make you understand. But again, I'll give you the notes there so that you will understand that. But this I've asked. Why I've asked it? I've asked that how much you know about it. वही मैं कहता हूँ ना कि यू मे रीड लॉट ऑफ करंट अफेयर्स मटेरियल बट बेसिक प्रिमाइस यू शुड ऑलवेज बी इन टच विद इट व्हाट यू हैव सेड इज वेरी राइट इज एक्सटेंशन ऑफ क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल पेरिस अग्रीमेंट नाउ एनी अदर पर्सन इन द क्लासरूम हु कैन गिव मी डिफरेंस बिटवीन क्योटो एंड पेरिस और ये दोनों इंपॉर्टेंट इस साल के एग्जाम के लिए 2020 इट कैन बी आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम यूपीएससी कैन आस्क यू द क्वेश्चन यूपीएससी विल नॉट आस्क यू मैड्रिड वो तो करंट में सबको पता है Right, it will come in PIB and everywhere. Sabko newspaper pata hai. Toh wahan competition nahi hua na. UPSC will not ask the question. But UPSC will go into the background, the prani cheez hai, and ask the question there. Kaun batayega?
Who will tell me? Protocol mein first commitment tha. Mein government differentiated para tha. Aur Paris Agreement mein nationally determined contribution ka
concept
hai.
Okay. पेरिस वाला वॉलंटरी है क्योटो वाला नहीं है अच्छा ठीक है एनीथिंग एल्स ये सब बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है दैट्स व्हाट आई टुडेज क्लास इज रियली इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज आई एम ब्रिंगिंग ऑल दिस एस्पेक्ट इन द क्लास रूम देयर फ्रॉम यूपीएससी पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू बोथ प्री एग्जाम एंड मेन एग्जाम दोनों के लिए कौन बताएगा इट्स वेरी सिंपल इट्स नॉट डिफिकल्ट वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड द थिंग्स इट विल नेवर बी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू So I'll do one thing. Just write in a note copy. That is the learning process has to be both ways. It should not be only one aspect of that. You should know, understand everything. So what I'm now doing here, you can just make this kind of a flow chart. UNFCCC, that's the main convention. And now I'm making here Kyoto Protocol. And I'm using the short form here, KP, right? And second bifurcation, Paris Agreement. PA, Right? Now I'll give you one by one everything. So let's say first one, number one. So you all know that. So I'm just bringing that. Brought in 1997 and ratified in which year I have mentioned the classroom? 2005. I'm giving this fact. Whereas Paris Agreement, when it was brought? 2015, Paris Summit, brought in 2015. Right? What do you call COP21 in Paris? And when it got ratified? It was ratified in 2016. Kyoto took 8 years for ratification, whereas Paris happened in just 1 year. Ye difference hai. Right? Second one, number two. Kyoto has two commitment period. What is the word here? Commitment period. Where they have to cut down the carbon emission. What is called here KP1. First commitment period was 2008, it was 2012. Right? And the target which was given to the annex 1 countries, that was 5% total target. Whereas the second commitment period is post 2012, that is a 2013 to 2020. As I said, Kyoto will end this year. This is the last year of Kyoto Protocol, second commitment period. And here the target to all these annex 1 countries, developed countries, has been raised to 18%. Because by the end of 2012, there was a Doha summit. Right? Where is Doha? Qatar. So Doha summit hua tha. So Doha summit mein ye agree kiya gaya ki continue kiya jayega. Kyoto will not end. तो बोला ठीक है कंटिन्यू करो लेकिन 5% तो पूरा नहीं हुआ तो मेनी कंट्रीज कि चलो 5% ही वहाँ पर है तो देवर कंट्रीज हु वांटेड टू एंड क्योटो सैबोटाइज क्योटो ख़त्म हो जाए ठीक है अमेरिका वाज वन ऑफ द कंट्री विच वांटेड टू एंड बिकॉज अमेरिका हैज़ नॉट साइंड एंड ज्वाइंट क्योटो तो क्योटो को ख़त्म करना चाह रहे थे कुछ कंट्री कह रहे थे नहीं क्योटो को रहने देना है उसको कंटिन्यू करना है लेकिन कमिटमेंट कम ही रहना चाहिए ज़्यादा नहीं होना चाहिए अब बहुत सारे कंट्री बोले कि नहीं पूरा नहीं हुआ है सजा तो मिलनी चाहिए तो सजा क्या है 18% बढ़ा दो इफ यू नॉट फुलफिल्ड बाय 2012 नाउ यू गो फॉर हायर कमिटमेंट बाय 2020 यू आर गेटिंग 8 ईयर्स टाइम अगेन नाउ कट डाउन 18% तो कुछ कंट्री वॉकआउट कर गया जैसे कनाडा वॉकड आउट फ्रॉम द वहाँ पर 18% करना इज नॉट ईजी टास्क इट विल बी गीगा टन्स ऑफ एमिशन नॉट वन गीगा टन्स टू रिड्यूस दैट एमिशन Now, what is about Paris? Number two here, Paris Agreement. Has it been implemented? No. Kab implement hoga? 2021. So, you can write here. To be implemented. To be implemented post 2020. And what will happen there after implementation? There will be something called stock taking review. With review every 5 years, with first जो review है, first stock taking, that means how much emission has been reduced in 2023. पहला review किया जाएगा 2023 में. Progress पता नहीं चाहिए नहीं कहाँ कितना हो रहा है नहीं हो रहा है. How much they are cutting down the emission, right? Now what I'm coming, the third point of the Kyoto and Paris. Who were legally bound? See, what is the word here? Protocol. Protocol is legally binding. They cannot backtrack. Karna hi hoga. Agreement may be binding, may not be binding. But protocol is always binding. So what comes here? It has a legally binding. I'm using the word here. Legally binding carbon emission reduction. So I am writing also there, carbon emission reduction targets. Now, when you set a target, what is very important? You have to also fix a year, baseline year. जितना कोटा करना है कुछ तो पता होना चाहिए ना कि 1990 से करना है या 1987 जाना है या 1890 जब रिवॉल्यूशन स्टार्ट हुआ था इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन. सो नाउ व्हाट आई एम कमिंग रिडक्शन टारगेट्स बेस्ड ऑन 1990 एमिशंस ऑल दिस कंट्रीज विच वेर एमिटिंग इन द ईयर 1990 बेस्ड ऑन द टारगेट वॉज कैलकुलेटेड. सो व्हाट आई हैव गिवन लीगली बाइंडिंग कार्बन एमिशन रिडक्शन टारगेट्स बेस्ड ऑन 1990 एमिशंस टू और नेक्स्ट वन कंट्रीज ओनली नो डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज इंडिया चाइना एंड ऑल वी आर नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द क्योटो दैट वी हैव साइन द क्योटो वी आर पार्ट ऑफ इट बट नो टारगेट्स हैव बीन गिवन टारगेट्स आर ओनली फॉर डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज. नाउ व्हाट अबाउट द पेरिस पेरिस में क्या है पेरिस एग्रीमेंट में क्या बात किया गया यहाँ तो लीगली बाइंडिंग है गिवन टू दिस व्हाट इज पेरिस हैज गॉट कौन बताएगा. दिस इज वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड कॉल्ड एनडीसी विच इज अर्लियर कॉल्ड INDC इंटेंडेड नेशनल डिटरमिनेशन. सो यू कैन राइट हियर दिस यू कैन राइट बेस्ड ऑन INDC आई एम राइटिंग इनवर्टेड कॉमा INDCs आई एम राइटिंग द ब्रैकेट हियर इंटेंडेड दिस वाज आस्क्ड इन 2016 प्री एग्जाम डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन वाज देयर इंटेंडेड नेशनली determined contribution close the bracket there based on INDCs intended national determined contribution submitted by the government right there submitted by member parties right. And now what has become this INDC? INDC was intended. What they want to intend. Intention kya hai? Ab Paris Agreement kya ho gaya? NDC ho gaya. Jab unhone intended kar diya, aur agree ho gaya, to ab nationally ho gaya. And become NDCs. And become NDCs in the Paris Agreement. अब इसको कहते हैं इंडियाज का NDC इंडियाज नेशनली डिटरमाइंड कंट्रीब्यूशन. अब क्वेश्चन उठता है कि वॉलंटरी या नॉन वॉलंटरी कौन बताएगा इसको. आई एम कीपिंग द पॉइंट देयर. ये तो लीगली बाइंडिंग है ना कि दे हैड टू डू इट इफ दे डोंट डू इट दे विल बी पनिश्ड. व्हाट पनिशमेंट फाइन हैवी फाइन हैज टू बी पेड. अब यहाँ पर पेरिस का correct. See, when INDC was there, it was voluntary. It was asked voluntary. Tell how much you are contribute. ठीक है? या दो वर्ड है यार याद रखना है. यहाँ वर्ड है commitment. You have to commit to cut down emission. But here what Paris talk about contribution. How much you will contribute in reducing the emission? दो अलग अलग वर्ड है वहाँ पर. तो वहाँ पर लीगली बाइंडिंग कमिटमेंट क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल हेयर द कंट्रीब्यूशन पार्ट. तो व्हेन दे वर इंटेंडेड दैट वाज वॉलंटरी एवरीबडी वाज आस्क्ड बताओ कितना करना है तुम्हारी मर्जी है जो बताना है. अब एक बार आपने बता दिया एग्री कर दिया NDC बन गया. अब नाउ इट इज अ बाइंडिंग. अब आप पीछे नहीं जा सकते. सो इट हैज़ अ मिक्स ऑफ बोथ वॉलंटरी एंड बाइंडिंग. NDCs आर बाइंडिंग याद रखना है. डोंट गेट कैरिड अवे बाय द वर्ड that Paris is not binding. Paris is binding. ठीक है NDC is binding. India cannot backtrack what India has committed. And for that what they will do in the Paris Agreement, they will have stock take review every 5 years. कि how much the country has met. ठीक है दूसरी बात second thing. Kyoto was top down. What is top down? उनसे consult नहीं किया गया था उनको कहा गया था करो. उसे नहीं पूछा गया था कि कितना करोगे. बोला गया कि यू आर अनेक्स वन कंट्रीज हिस्टोरिकली रिस्पॉन्सिबल दिस आर योर टारगेट्स ना यू डू इट. ठीक है यहाँ पे क्या है बॉटम अप. पहले पूछा गया कि बताओ कितना करना है ऑन योर वॉलंटरी ग्राउंड एंड देन एग्रीमेंट वॉज ड्राफ्टेड. So this is another comment, top down, bottom up. Yesterday Paris is more revolutionizing than Kyoto in terms of more participation. Paris has more participation than Kyoto. और यहाँ पे एक और क्या बात है, पेरिस में क्या क्या है, वहाँ अनेक्स वन कंट्री है, यहाँ पे ऑल पेरिस कवर्स डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज ऑल्सो, लाइक इंडिया वॉज नॉट बाउंड देयर इन क्योटो, बट इंडिया इज नाउ बाउंड इन द पेरिस. सो व्हाट आई वांट टू ब्रिंग हियर, बेस्ड ऑन इंडिसेस एंड बिकम इंडिसेस इन द पीए बाय ऑल मेंबर स्टेट्स, बाय ऑल मेंबर कंट्रीज, बाय ऑल मेंबर पार्टीज. Now there is no difference annex 1 and non-annex 1. Kyoto comes into annex 1 and non-annex 1. Okay? Now I am coming very important point. Fourth one, finance. Kitna Kyoto finance diya gaya? How much finance was given? Kyoto here, I am now writing a very important word. Green Climate Fund. GCF bolte hain. Green Climate Fund, which is managed by World Bank and all this. Green Climate Fund was set up in the 2010. Cancun Summit was there. Cancun in, where is Cancun? Mexico. 2010 mein banaya gaya tha. And how much the commitment was the developed country? Who will give the finance? Developed countries. To developing countries, not the... So what was commitment? $100 billion. $100 billion given by developed countries to developing countries. That's called Green Climate Fund. ठीक है, अब मुझे आप बताइए how much Paris Agreement talks about finance? That's why America is now out. कितना billion? ये तो $100 billion पहले से ही है, क्यों तुम देना है additional $100 billion? और उसमें बात किया, सो हियर यू हैव एडिशनल, यू राइट एडिशनल 100 बिलियन यूएस डॉलर फ्रॉम 2021 टू 2025. टाइम लाइन भी बताया गया, बाय 2025 दे शुड गिव $100 बिलियन मोर, सो इट बिकम्स $200 बिलियन, राइट. एंड now what I am coming here, before Madrid, what was the COP, where was the COP 2018, where was the Katowice COP 24, accounting was confirmed. Ab jo uska accounting karna hoga na, how much money, how much carbon emission, that was finalized in Katowice, Poland, COP 24, right. You should know the recent COP, 5-6 saal ka COP pata hona chahiye. COP 21 Paris, when the agreement was brought. COP 22 Marrakesh, that was in Morocco, where the Paris was finalized. COP 23 Bonn, Germany, right. Fiji was the head, but Fiji cannot handle, so Fiji are organized in Bonn, Germany. COP 24 Katowice, where all the accounting and everything was finalized. And then COP 25 Madrid, in terms of the Paris Agreement, which will be implemented next year. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पर ये चीज़ है. अब यहां पर एक और चीज है, पांचवा पॉइंट, क्लैरिटी. यू नीड क्लैरिटी, दैट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. इफ यू क्लियर अबाउट इट, यू विल नॉट फाइंड प्रॉब्लम इन एग्जामिनेशन. टू इन ऑर्डर टू मीट द कमिटमेंट बाय अंडर क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल, देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड कार्बन मार्केट मैकेनिज्म, कार्बन क्रेडिट, CDM, जॉइंट इंप्लीमेंटेशन वाज ब्रॉट. तो वेयर दिस कार्बन मार्केट केम फर्स्ट टाइम, क्योटो. सो राइट हियर, provision of, right, provision of carbon market mechanism to meet commitment, right. What is called here, I am writing bracket, one is called carbon credit, emission trading scheme bolte hain isko, carbon credit system. Second is called CDM, Clean Development Mechanism, and third is called Joint Implementation, JI. Now tell me, in Paris Agreement, okay, the first time the carbon market concept, which is brought in the Kyoto, was there. So what is Paris talks about? Paris is more holistic than Kyoto. It talks about clean technology, like International Solar Alliance, solar technology promotion, right? Smart agriculture, all these abroad. So here, Sustainable Development Mechanism, SDM. It talks about SDM, Sustainable Development Mechanism. There we were talking only carbon, but it's talking beyond carbon, right? With promotion of clean technology. Uske liye separate fund kiya gaya hai, promotion of clean technology. We have to become carbon neutral. IPCC says that there has to be zero emission, net zero emission by 2050. So clean technology has become very important. That's what 2015 Paris summit, ISA was launched, International Solar Alliance. India and France came together. And India is the head of that. Gurugram, we have a center called NISE. Another platform was Mission Innovation, MI, in order to promote clean technology. I clearly difference diya. In your handout, the handout which you have got, there also have given Paris and the part of it. Here I have differentiated there. Right? So what I'll do here, all I've written this part. So for whenever you revise your class notes, you'll be able to get there. So Kyoto Protocol I have discussed. Annex 1 countries I have gone into that. Doha and this Kyoto Protocol. And I've said this is a three mechanism. International Trading Scheme, Clean Development Mechanism, Joint Implementation. Right? Ab yahan pe ek word aata hai, Annex A, Annex B. Ab ye samajhna kya hai, Annex A, Annex B. Annex A are those countries which were only part of the first commitment period, 2008 to 2012. But when you say Annex B, are all those Annex 1 countries which are part of both commitment period 1 and the 2. They are called Annex B countries. ठीक है कहीं पर अगर Annex B word आता है, इसमें वो countries है जो कि पहले commitment में भी था Kyoto में और अभी भी है. अब जैसे मैंने बताया Canada, तो Canada is Annex A. Why? Canada has walked out. Second commitment period में नहीं है. ठीक है. तो that part I've given joint implementation and all this part of it. Now let me just come to this one. This is the summit when Paris happened there. Paris Climate Agreement. So now see, 196 countries adopted this agreement. Just a brief outline. And whatever I have discussed, ek aur cheez Paris Agreement mein rakha gaya, jo maine class mein bataya, ki countries decided to limit at 1.5. Right? Not too late to 2 degrees Celsius. And 1.5 degrees Celsius. Finance and everything. And the emission target, which I said, by 2050, world should become carbon neutral. What is carbon neutral means? No emission? No. Whatever we are emitting, we are able to capture also, reduce also, balance. That will be done by 2050. Now comes to the last part, then we'll be taking a break there. There are people who are climate change denial. They deny the carbon, there is no carbon climate change. Like for example, it's not urgent. Rince Priebus, White House Chief of Staff. Look, I think we all care about our planet, but melting icebergs aren't beheading Christians in the Middle East. अब ये सारे स्टेटमेंट है पॉलिटिकिशियन का है. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट द स्टेटमेंट सेज? कि द फाइटिंग सीरिया इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट देन फाइटिंग क्लाइमेट चेंज. दैट इज व्हाट द स्टेटमेंट. चीफ ऑफ स्टाफ नाउ सी व्हाइट हाउस, अनदर डिनायल. रेक्स टिलरसन, सेक्रेटरी ऑफ स्टेट, व्हाट ही हैज सेड नाउ सी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. द इंक्रीज इन ग्रीन हाउस गैस कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इन द एटमोसफेयर आर हैविंग एन इफेक्ट. तो पहले तो एक्नोलेजमेंट इज देयर. नाउ सेकेंड पार्ट, our ability to predict that effect is very limited. The first is admitting ki yahan effect hai, lekin the prediction kar rahe hain wo limited hai, matlab kuch kaha nahi ja sakta hai ki aisa hoga hi hoga. So he is putting a doubt. Ye IPCC report wagra usme pata nahi hai na, to wo cheez hai. Ab yahan par ye panch characteristics hai science denial ka. Pehla bolte hai fake report hai ye sab. वैज्ञानिक लोग जानबूझ के कर रहे हैं. देर इज नो साइंटिफिक बेसिस ऑफ दैट. ये डिनाइल हम तभी कर सकते हैं ना. हाउ वी कैन डिनाई? वी से दिस फेक है ना, फेक है ये. सो वी विल नॉट एक्नॉलेज दैट. सेकेंड वर्ड कम लॉजिस्टिक फैलेसिस, इसमें जो चीज़ें वो फॉल इम्पॉसिबल एक्सपेक्टेशन है. ऐसा कभी होगा ही नहीं कि पूरा वर्ल्ड ही सिंक कर जाए, द इंटायर आर्टिक विल मेल्ट, दोस काइंड ऑफ. देन चेरी पिकिंग, ये सारी रिपोर्ट में है ना है ना, डराने का काम करते हैं या कुछ अच्छे बताने के जो है. चेरी पिकिंग मतलब कुछ कुछ चीज़ों को हाईलाइट ज़्यादा करते हैं, सबको नहीं बताते हैं. यही है ना, जब रिपोर्ट हम पढ़ते हैं तो वहाँ क्या लगता है, ओ सी लेवल राइज, दैट इज चेरी पिकिंग राइट, एक्सट्रीम वेदर इवेंट, व्हाट आर अदर इम्पैक्ट्स, ये चीज़ है. फिर कॉन्स्पिरेसी थ्योरी कि ग्रुप ऑफ साइंटिस्ट देयर आर, कि दबाव डाला जाए, ये ना कॉन्स्पिरेसी है कि हाउ कैन पुट प्रेशर ऑन द गवर्नमेंट, यू ब्रिंग सम काइंड ऑफ थिंग इन द रिपोर्ट, द गवर्नमेंट विल कम अंडर प्रेशर. और उसमें एक होता है कॉन्स्पिरेसी थ्योरी अगेंस्ट डेवलपिंग कंट्री, इंडिया एंड चाइना, यही होगा ना. हाउ यू कैन चेंज बर्डन फ्रॉम डेवलप टू डेवलपिंग. अगर ये बना दिया कि चाइना इज द हाईएस्ट पोल्यूटर, चाइना से ये हो रहा है, ये भी हो सकता है. समटाइम दिस काइंड ऑफ लॉबी हैपेंस कि व्हाट साइंटिफिक रिपोर्ट इज देयर. देन व्हाट कम्स हियर, मैग्नीफाइड माइनॉरिटी, जो माइनॉरिटी जो है जिसमें ज़्यादा है. अब जैसे फिजी, टुवालू, मॉरिशस, मालदीव, उसको जबरदस्ती हाईलाइट किया जा रहा है, स्मॉल आइलैंड कंट्रीज. डूबेगा तब देखा जाएगा ना, अब तो डूब नहीं रहे ना. उनको पहले डरा रहे हैं कि अब डूब रहे हो, आप जा रहे हो पानी के अंदर राइट. ये चीज़ है वहाँ पर. देन कम्स रेड हेरिंग. रेड हेरिंग मीन्स यही होता है कि जो छोटे छोटे चीज़ों को ज़्यादा बढ़ाना. फिर देन कम्स मिस रिप्रेजेंटेशन, कई बार फैक्ट आर नॉट करेक्ट. देन वॉट कम्स जंपिंग टू कंक्लूजन, कि दैट IPCC इज जस्ट जंपिंग टू कंक्लूजन कि दिस विल हैव वॉट हैपन, लेट वेट फॉर सम टाइम, है ना. जब सब कुछ हो जाए, दो डिग्री सेल्सियस आ जाए, तब हम लोग देखेंगे कि व्हाट एग्जैक्टली व्हाट हैपेंस. एंड देन फॉल्स डिकोटोमी, समटाइम जो होता है कि समटाइम द रिपोर्ट सेज यस हाई रिस्क एंड समटाइम विल बी कंट्रोवर्शियल, नेगेटिंग दैट फैक्ट. तो ये सब ग्राउंड है जिसमें जो है देर आर पीपल हु कैन से दैट दस सच रिपोर्ट्स आर रॉन्ग राइट. सो दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव ब्रॉट हियर. सो दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव केप्ट इन द फर्स्ट सेशन. Whatever I have given as a handout, whatever I am teaching in the classroom, just go through that, plus current affairs, add the current affairs, right? So you will be safe from everywhere. You'll have every aspect covered in that part. Okay? So we'll take a break here. After the break, the story continues, right? So we'll be coming to that. So ICRA IAS, what we are covering here, so we will be continuing with the part. So after the break, I will be covering the climate change is carbon market mechanism, what I've just mentioned. And we'll see India's role in climate change, the national level of climate change targets and how we are going to cover that, NAPCC and all that part we'll cover in the classroom. And then we'll go to pollution part. And I've given pollution part with current aspect. We'll be covering that. And we'll end up with EIA, in water impact assessment. Okay? So you can relax for a while and come back. Just one second. हाँ ठीक है. हाँ जेंडर, जेंडर एस्पेक्ट ऑल्सो यू कैन टेक, क्लाइमेट चेंज, लॉस एंड डैमेज, जेंडर एस्पेक्ट, पेरिस एग्रीमेंट, इट वॉज देन एक्नोलॉज्ड इन द बॉन समिट COP23 में होता, वो पार्ट भी है. व्हाट आई हैव कवर्ड इज द बेसिक एरिया, बट अगेन यू हैव टू कनेक्ट. अच्छा, इन द हैंड आउट इफ यू सी द क्लाइमेट चेंज हैंड आउट, आई हैव गिवन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ टर्म ऑल्सो, ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, क्लाइमेट चेंज. यू कैन सी द सॉफ्ट कॉपी, यू हैव ऑलरेडी हैव दैट. So today being the like photocopy is not possible, so that's what I have, you have been shared with the document there. Okay? So anyway, you'll be getting the hard copy, don't worry about that, but just go through that one. Kaun sa? Haan, Himalayan effect is sab jo hai. Melting of glacier jo ho raha hai, sara je hai. Ye sara impact bhi hai. Isliye bataya ki current affairs, what I'll do? Current affairs I'll cover in current affairs class. Like what I'm asking in the classroom? To go through the current affairs. But in the month of April, before the pre-exam, that will be current related topics. And there I'll cover all the current part of it. Climate change, current aspect will also come there. Whether Himalayan effect or gender aspect or Madrid summit, we'll be covering that. Okay? So this part is syllabus ka jo main aapko bata raha hu class mein. So we'll be covering that one. Alright? So we'll take a break here and then we'll continue after the break there. Alright? Thank you everyone. Thank you.